I don't think you're robbing anymore.
You buy beaters and you leave your trucks alone because you're going to lose your ass.
This is the third installment on the Come and Swap video.
What am I building?
Yeah.
Long arms for the white truck.
Where'd you get them from?
Far From Stock, but Far From Stock does not make it. The Rough Stuff Specialties does.
Is their actual name Rough Stuff Specialties?
Yeah.
Okay.
Rough.
Well, they're not making sure anything's level or anything.
Oh yeah, I bought it. Let's say Johnny Joint. Yeah, I need to swap that out for a regular grease fit.
It's freaking massive. That is a weird grease fit.
Yeah, I'm not sure if I'm supposed to cut those down. Hopefully not. Also, not real sure how I'm going to center the wheel well. Like, where the fuck's the center of that wheel well?
You coming? Wait, hold on, stop. We need to move this axle back some more.
The diff hitting those. It's going to.
At this point, Mason realizes it's gonna suck to do this.
It looks like.
The only thing I can tell you is we need to custom make bottom leaf purges.
As in, move them over as far as you can.
But you're gonna have to come up like 3 inches and then go over.
Well, that's what I'm saying. You
know, I got a feeling the Fords are wider.
How hard is it to make perches here? Mason. Dill hole.
That's a good idea. I didn't think about that. I'm doing coilovers. Big brains over here. The cowboy hat.
No,
I suppose you can fit that on there with your big old brain.
They make different sizes, asshole.
What I'm saying is you'll keep this mount.
Bottom part, the mount, here. The actual mount itself, but yeah. This will come over.
Because you see how it's already.
Right, it's already garbage.
We lopped this top, the actual perch itself off. And we'll take a piece of flat stock, make it our diameter of our spring.
Put that
as far over as we can because we don't need that much. We need about.
Look, if we literally came over.
If we moved them probably half an inch on both sides,
we'd be solid.
I've discovered that the spring mounts were too far. Too narrow, so I've had to cut those off, weld plates on, move them out. I just welded on the little bucket that the spring's gonna sit in so it can't walk wherever. I've made my 4-link arms, and now we're ready to center up the axle and weld the long arm mounts to the frame.
You got a house start building here soon.
Yeah, I know. I gotta get this thing rolling by the end of the week. I bet underneath those motor mounts is centered.
That does look pretty freaking center.
And I can adjust it with that rod a little bit.
Okay. You got to put the long arm, the arms on, aren't you? Okay. I didn't know what you were doing.
And if these welds fail, it's only the whole fucking truck that's gonna fall apart.
Whoa.
We got the bottom and top spring mounts tacked on and the springs in and then just kind of set the truck on it. I don't know, it seems right, but it doesn't look right.
It just sits really high.
Well, not only does it not sit high, but it doesn't seem like the top arms are going to clear.
This episode will be to be continued in like 2 months when Mason has time to work on this again.
Well, it's because you have a house.
And if anybody needs parts, name your prize. Calling it a night and calling it an episode.
I feel like we got somewhere.
We definitely got somewhere. But
it's just working out the kinks now.
Yeah, a lot of kinks.
We became very discouraged with the Cummins swap, so we decided to take a quick break and finish something that really needed to be finished anyway, which was undercoating Mason's Duramax, which literally turned out the exact way the Cummins swap did, with Mason wanting to sell the Duramax also.
Hunter, I got bad news.
What?
Look at my rocker. I think it's rusted through.
Oh, right there?
Yeah. Pretty sure that's rusted through.
That is rusted through. I feel like you're actually wanting to sell this now.
Yeah.
Are you really?
I'm kind of thinking about it. 6 hour blow. What, let it go as it is? Or do I keep a bunch of the parts off of it?
Just sell the motherfucker like it is if you're gonna sell it. But you better put it up there for $23K at least.
Hey, we
Jesus
got...
Christ.
Hey.
Let's... I gotta sell it, try to sell it for more than that.
Kumbaya. Here's an idea.
Buy. You do not buy fucking trucks. You buy beaters, like that Jeep over there, and you leave your trucks alone, because you're going to lose your ass every time. I had the batteries unhooked when we welded that thing to the bed, and when I hooked the batteries back up, everything was in metric. Like the, my thing digitally tells you how hot or cold it is in the cab. It was in kilometers, it was in Celsius.
Did you switch it back?
Yeah.
Okay, good.
But I had a mini heart attack. Check out the bottom of that door. Yeah, sick nasty. Extra nasty, a little bit of sick.
So what do you think, your plan is for this?
Lots of crying.
Cowgirls don't cry.
This cowboy does. Sandblast some little giblets. Giblets in my little blasting cabinet.
So this is what this thing looked like before, covered in tire, black paint, and chrome. Look at that real quick. All right. That's after. I don't know how this stuff works, but it literally took the rust all the way off, straight down to the metal. So I'm gonna do this little patch back here because it's just like chunky, and I don't know how it's gonna do on chunks, and there's some undercoat still on there, so I'm just gonna kinda like, it. This stuff's like gooey and nasty, so I don't, it kind of scares me honestly. Oh, I got on my hand, that's probably not safe. Just look at the white residue left behind by that stuff though, like. That's got like pressure.
Look at that.
No,
spray. Look at the tip of that thing. You see how fast it sprayed out?
It's like a dovetail looking tip on it.
Turbo spray system. 4 times faster than traditional spray paint. For large projects, no shit.
For 4 times the amount of runs?
But so. Well,
yeah. Well, most places do.
I have no idea what you just said, Austin. Shoot. Swallow your food.
Use your words.
I got fucking chew it first, you fucking idiot.
Yeah.
Jack it up, Sally.
I have to sign. Hold on. I don't think you're rubbing anymore.
Oh my god.
You're not rubbing anymore.
Oh, you hit it right there.
Oh, I didn't.
It'll be alright.
Oh my god. Mason, you know it was already pretty much like that.
Oh yeah, no, this is what you fix it with. You don't cut, you beat.
I don't know how I'm gonna hit this side without Mason cringing.
Didn't do that. You fool.
This was already here.
Yeah.
He's bitching at me and it's already peeled.
Yeah, but it wasn't damaged, was it?
Yeah. Oh my god! Woo! How'd it look from back there?